No, I'm not paying.
Well, I can't say I'm pleased to hear that. We have rules, you know.
Right. We get to ransack your corpse, then. Those are the rules.
You can certainly try.
Well, this is going nowhere. Let's finish this, gents. Surrender. We're just trying to get by before the darkspawn get us all.
Get by? You're a fucking criminal.
Yes, I'm a criminal. I admit it. I apologize.
Well,
what
could
I tell you? We aren't even from these parts.
What's going on?
It's packed full. The band took his men north with Tern Loghain, so there's no one looking out for it except a few Templars at the Chantry. Well, I was just trying to feed my family, you know?
And the other
couple,
survivors.
Maybe. A group of wounded Ash Warriors came by earlier. Got right out of their way.
What other news have you heard?
Everyone's saying how the Grey Wardens betrayed the king during the Darkspawn fight. Got him and themselves killed. Tern Loghain pulled out just in time. First thing he's doing as regent is putting a bounty on Grey Wardens. Well, watching for folks fleeing from the south. Chasing from the wilds and farmholders, mostly. There aren't soldiers here anymore, so we help ourselves. We try not to hurt anyone too much. Well, then, let me go!
No, you'll come with me. I need
soldiers.
What
are you joking, right? I could never be a soldier. I'm not going down without a fight!
Dead Templar. There's a locket and a note. New quest. And a new codex note from Sir Henrik. Found some scale armor.
Well, there it is. Lothering. Pretty as a painting.
Ah, so you have finally decided to rejoin us, have you? Falling on your blade in grief seemed like too much trouble, I take it.
Is my being upset so hard to understand? Have you never lost someone important to you? Just what would you do if your mother died?
Before or after I stopped laughing.
Right, very creepy. Forget I asked.
What do you want
He's
to talk
naval,
about?
I suspect. He certainly has been contemplating it for long enough.
Oh, I get it. This is the part where we're shocked to discover how you've never had a friend your entire life.
I can be friendly when I desire to. Alas, desiring to be more intelligence does not make it so.
Anyway, I thought we should talk about where we intend to go first.
Okay, so now we're planning out our adventure, huh? No way this could go wrong. Okay, where should we go?
I agree. Have you looked at them?
Yeah.
There are three main groups that we have treaties for. The Dalish Elves, the Dwarves of Orzammar, and the Circle of Magi. I also still think that Ahriman is our best bet for help. We might even want to go to him first.
Any way to contact the others?
Short of leading Ferelden to seek them out, the only place to send word to would be Weishaupt Fortress. And that's thousands of miles away.
And that's not helpful. So why are you leaving this up to me again?
Well, I don't know where we should go. I'll do whatever you decide.
Now that is unsurprising.
Ahriman is a good man, but I don't know for sure he's where we should go. I'm not going to fight about it.
What do you think, Morgan?
Go after your enemy directly. Find this man Loghain and kill him. The rest of this business with the treaties can then be done in safety.
Yes, he certainly wouldn't see that coming, and it's not like he has the advantage of an army and experience and...
I was asked for my opinion, and I gave it. If your wish is to come up with reasons why something cannot be done, we will stand here until the Darkspawn are upon us.
Yeah, let's not do that.
Fair enough. Good to go. Let's head into the village whenever you're ready.
Elfruit.
So let's talk about your mother for a moment.
I'd rather talk about your mother.
Well, there's nothing to talk about. And besides, isn't your mother a scary witch who lives in the middle of a forest? Much more interesting.
To you, perhaps. You would find the moss growing upon a stone interesting.
You know what's more interesting than that? Apostates, mages outside of the tower. That's illegal, you know.
You did not read that in a book somewhere, did you? I hope the small letters did not strain you overmuch.
Oh, we could not talk about your mother. That works for me.
All these poor refugees.
I brought my family to Lothring because I thought it would be safe.
The answer is, you were wrong. More elf fruit. Yeah, rule one of playing this game, you gotta go everywhere. You gotta collect everything.
You there! If you're looking for safe shelter, I'll warn you, there's none to be found.
Hey, that sounds like Fenris.
We were lucky. We had the coin to pay the toll to those bandits. Many didn't.
Ah, look how they moan and wail and gnash their teeth. It is sad to watch how helplessly they scurry about.
Who are you? Can you protect us?
Greetings to you, good sir. If it isn't too much to ask, might you spare some bread or anything? We thought it would be safer in Lothring, that the Terran would bring his soldiers here. But bandits attacked us and took everything. Our food, our clothes, my daughter's pet lamb.
Not the
Nobody
pet lamb.
Nobody cares about a few elves. Can you help us?
Not the pet lamb. I feel better. I killed those bandits.
You killed them?
That's wonderful news. Perhaps our belongings are still there.
I can't thank you enough, friend. Even if we don't get everything back, it's good to know others will be safe.
I'm cold. I don't like
it. The chanters are still operating their board.
And I even spoke unto the masses, my hearth is yours, my bread is yours, my life is yours. For all who walk in the sight of the Maker are one.
Say what?
Let all repeat the chant of light. Only the word dispels the darkness upon us.
He can't answer you. He's Chanter Devons.
The fuck? Is he tushing her head or something?
No, he's a chanter. One of them that can only say the chant of light. His board has letters of good deeds to be doing. My father fixed Widow Allison's roof once, and the charter paid him, he did.
A learned child is a blessing upon his parents and onto the Maker.
So it's like a vow of silence?
Unless it's the chant of light, no.
And so Rajmael in the heathen temple recanted. Speak only the word, sing only the chant, then the golden city is thine, spoke Andraste.
Chanter says what?
What?
Oh, you got him to speak. Ha!
What hath man's sin wrought?
Oh, he cheated.
I love doing that every single time. Every single time. Kill all bandits. Gotcha. But I love doing that to the chanter every single time.
I don't like this.
Stop looking at me, mongrel. I have nothing you want. Why do you keep staring at me so, you flea-ridden beast? Can you not tell when you are not wanted? I enjoy company of creatures of the wild, not stench-ridden domesticated wolves. And he persists. Maddening!
Terran Loghain is the new regent. Isn't that
awesome?
I heard that he may have had something to do with the king's death.
I thought Darkspawn killed the king. That doesn't make any sense.
It's probably political nonsense. We'll be lucky if they don't burn down the entire country fighting over the throne.
Mm-hmm. Fair
you
point.
You spoke to that knight yesterday. Said he was from Redcliffe.
He talked to everyone in the town.
So, into this place.
Well, look what we have here, then. I think we've just been blessed.
Uh-oh. Loghain's men. This can't be good.
Didn't we spend all morning asking about a fellow by this very description? And everyone said they hadn't seen him.
It seems we were lying.
Gentlemen, surely there's no need for trouble. These are no doubt simply more poor souls seeking refuge.
They're more than that. Now stay out of our way, sister. You protect these traitors, you'll get the same as them.
There's a sister. I'm a mage. Yeah, I'm a Grey Warden, but I'm a mage too. So I got two groups of people that don't like me right now. Let's talk about this.
I doubt he would listen. He blindly follows his master's commands.
I am not the blind one. I served at Ostagar, where the Tern saved us from the Grey Warden's treachery. I serve him gladly. Enough talk. Take the Warden into custody. Kill this sister and anyone else that gets in your way.
Right. Let's make this quick.
Come and get
right, you've won. We surrender.
Good. They've learned their lesson and we can all stop fighting now.
Take a message.
What do you want to tell him?
Grey Wardens know the truth.
I'll tell him right away. Now, thank you.
Get out of here.
I apologize for interfering. But I couldn't just sit by and not help.
I appreciate that.
I am glad you found it in your heart to offer those men mercy. Let me introduce myself. I am Liliana, one of the lay sisters of the Chantry here in Lothering. Oh, I was. Those men said you're a Grey Warden. You will be battling the Darkspawn, yes? That is what Grey Wardens do. I know after what happened, you will need all the help you can get. That's why I'm coming along. That, and the Maker wants me to go with you.
What?
I know that sounds absolutely insane, but it's true. I had a dream. A vision.
More crazy? I thought we were all full up.
Look at the people here. They are lost in their despair, and this darkness, this chaos, will spread. The Maker doesn't want this. What you do, what you are meant to do, is the Maker's work. Let me help.
Perhaps your skull was cracked worse than Mother thought.
Thank you. I appreciate being given this chance. I will not let you down.
Blast and damnation!
So, first things first, need to outfit her with proper fighting equipment. Chainmail gloves, chainmail boots, chainmail. Tactics. Behavior will be ranged. Behavior details of cautious. Set up her tactics, so she's gonna constantly try to, you know, be away from people.
You're here about food.
She'll attack people that are next to her if she needs to, but
I got other gear to sell. Check the chanter's board by the chantry. There's good jobs there. I don't suppose you know anything about poison. I figured if I kept asking, I'd find someone. I'd pay good coin for some simple poison. Something to slow them beasties down or make them think twice. Well, there's herbs in the North Wood. As for other stuff, look around town. Some refugees just left things behind to travel faster. I don't really know what you need, though. I might have some in stock, too.
So show me what you got. What do we got here? Ooh, that one's useful. This compared to, yeah, we'll sell them all. leather boots. Sell the chantry robe. And we'll save the rest for now. Alright. So I need a few flasks here.
Make more trouble? We've about all we can stand in Lothering now.
Sorry about the mess.
Coming, and they were trouble enough themselves. So long as you don't start more, I won't get excited. Right then, name's Denarl. Sorry I can't chat much. As you see, we've a full house.
There any rumors?
Knights from Redcliffe wandering the countryside, looking for the place where Andraste's sacred ashes are said to lie. Can you believe that? The urn holding her ashes is a myth. And yet these knights say they were sent to find it anyhow to heal Aralene. I didn't even know he was ill. Maybe he has a blight. If so, then times are even darker for Ferelden than any of us thought. Anything else I can get you? I hear news from Denarum that Tyrn Loghain has been declared the new regent. It makes sense, his daughter being the queen. Anything else I can get you?
Any more rumors?
Tyrn Loghain, the regent, is calling for new levies of troops. He wants to rebuild the army we lost at Astagar. Thing is, there's not a lot of spare men to be found. Out at Dragon's Peak, there's press gangs roaming around, grabbing any free man they can lay their hands on. Anything else I can get you? Look around. People are sleeping on the floors and in the attic. That's how many rooms I don't have.
All right, well, I'll be going. Speed
your way.
Who are you? Can you protect us?
Finished.
This is why I swapped to having Liliana versus Morgan.
So what does a darkspawn look like anyhow? Have you ever seen one?
Can't say I want to.
We're probably going to see plenty sooner or later.
I say later. Much later.
You got a bed for the night. You taken care of.
What's going on
Ever
here?
Since good King Kaelin passed, refugees and soldiers have been passing through. I'm the elder here, and I've my hands full making sure refugees don't turn to petty theft, or worse. Sir Bryant at the Chantry has seen to matters of defense and such. He'd have more of an ear for your type. too much to do, and not enough time.
Do you need any help?
Don't suppose you know anything of tonics, medicines, or herbs. Then you may be able to do us a lot of good. All manner of travelers come through, many injured or sick. We do our best, but we're out of supplies. There's medicinal herbs in the woods to the north. If you make a few poultices, I'll scrape together some sort of payment. I'll write all you need to know in this note here.
Allow me. I could do that for you. What now?
Have any luck finding herbs in the woods? This will help many people. You're a good sort, you know.
Yeah, it's only 5 silver, but... No, it's 50 silver.
Just how smart are Mabari supposed to be, anyway? Do you think they understand everything we say? Oh, is that so? You could just be listening to the tone of my voice. You could be an utter moron for all we know. Hey, now. There's nothing saying that a moron can't be cute and adorable. Who's the cute and adorable puppy? Ignorance is bliss, isn't it? That's what the Chantry kept telling me anyhow.
Alrighty. So let's go kill some bandits. And figure out what that exclamation point is there.
How dare you accuse me of thievery? I saw you take the
Shock Gibbus. You aren't one of my captors. I will not amuse you any more than I have the other humans. Leave me in peace. A prisoner. I'm in a cage, am I not? I've been placed here by the Chantry.
The revered mother said he slaughtered an entire family, even the children.
It is as she says. I am Sten of the Beresad, the vanguard of the Kunari peoples. Mock me, or you show manners I have not come to expect in your lands. Though it matters little now, I will die soon enough.
Not to put too fine a point on it, but Kunari are renowned warriors. If we could release him, perhaps he might help us.
I suggest you leave me to my fate. No doubt. What help do you seek? Blight. Are you a Grey Warden, then?
Yes, I am a Grey Warden.
Surprising.
Oh.
People have heard legends of the Grey Warden's strength and skill. Though I suppose not every legend is true. Perhaps if you told her the Grey Wardens need my assistance, it seems as likely to bring my death as waiting here.
Yes. Yes, it will. I'll leave.
Farewell, then.
To be left here to starve? Or to be taken by the Darkspawn? No one deserves that. Not even a murderer.
go get some bandits. Next time, Alistair, don't fall down on the job. Alistair levels up, I'm gonna need to put something into his constitution. So he doesn't keep dying. I could also start upgrading his armor to scale mail, I guess. Should be some more bandits over here-ish, maybe. We'll stick with the crossbow. Because for whatever reason, a crossbow... Well, actually, yeah. Even in real life, crossbows do more damage. Yeah, let's go ahead and junk the split now. Okay, we finished the Chancer's Board stuff. So let's head on back. Here we go. It's always awkward when you approach the ambush from behind.
You're a warden. I don't know if you killed King Kaelin, and make her forgive me, I don't care. But that bounty on your head could feed a lot of hungry bellies. Attack!
All the noise and bother.
Yeah.
Done.
Poor refugees. I need more toxin extract.
So, let me get this straight. You were a cloistered sister?
You must have been a brother before you became a Templar.
Mother!
No?
Where are you?
I never actually became a Templar. I was recruited into the Grey Wardens before I took my final vows.
Do you ever regret leaving the Chantry?
No, never. Do you?
Yes. You may not believe it, but I found peace there.
I don't like this.
The kind of peace I've never known.
It used to get so quiet at the monastery that I would start screaming until one of the brothers came running. I would tell them that I was just checking. Oh, you never know, right?
Mother, where are you?
The path of righteousness is full of hardship, but the Maker smiles upon its travelers.
Here we go. Let's go take care of some bears. And maybe some wolves.
Poor animals.
I found.
What now? Great. Now we're getting rabies planters.
Care of the bears. Now leveled up. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and become a spirit healer. Group heal. Why are we a spirit healer? One very, very simple reason. Right there, revive. Revive fallen party members in an area. And also this one, cleansing aura. Basically, when people. You restore health and you prevent injuries to people because you cure them right away. So, yeah, it's pretty damn useful. Yeah, keeping people alive.
What should we do here?
Kill the spiders. I'm gonna go with the distillation needed and improved herbalism. But
come, let's have a move on.
Make all of that.
What do you need?
Never mind. I need to get something from this giant spider. Missed mercenary archer corpse. Okay. Going here, get rewarded for making poison.
Poison? Or you're here to see my stock? Splendid! If those beasties come on my land, I hope it teaches them a lesson. Yeah, enough gold to cover any of your expenses and then some, hey?
one. Even the Grey Wardens didn't make it out of that place down south.
I heard he saw just in time what those Grey Wardens were doing to save his head.
You're such a ham.
Have you seen my mother? She's really tall, and she has red hair. We live on a big farmhold, all of us. The main men with swords came, and Mother told me to run to the village as fast as I could, so I did. She said she'd be right behind me, but I've been waiting and waiting, and I can't see her. Mother said I wasn't to go with anyone. I'm supposed to wait for her here, in the village. I will, but only if I don't find Mother first. You're a really nice man, kind of like Father. I should go look for Mother now.
So yeah, his mother's already dead. We just
let him take notice and shine upon thee, for thou hast done his work this day. And the stars stood still, the winds did quiet, and all animals of earth and air held their breath. All was silent in prayer and thanks.
Here there's a raving lunatic.
The legions of evil are on your doorstep! They will feast upon our hearts! There is nowhere to run! This evil will cover the world like a plague of locusts!
Please, you're scaring the children!
Better to slit their throats now than let them suffer at Darkspawn hands! There! One of their minions is already amongst us! This man bears their evil stench! Can you not see the vile blackness that fills him?
Be my guest. I've no urge to try out that axe of his.
I watched the Black Horde descend on my people! Darkness swallowed the marshes whole! This minion is but the first of those who will destroy us! No! I have seen them! You cannot run! You cannot fight! My family, my clan, those creatures butchered them all. Some of us fled here, but we cannot escape the Darkspawn! No! I won't listen to the words of a man tainted by Darkspawn! I ran, hearing my wife's screams as they dragged her off. Are you calling me a coward? I have shamed my ancestors, but the blackness will come.
He was right, wasn't he? There's no hope for us. You're right. We can't give up.
But we can't fight. What are we supposed to do?
We can't lie down and die either. We must go north to Denerim.
There we go. So we shut him up. Now let's go ahead and put some points into Constitution for Alistair, make him a little bit more of a tank. There we go. So that gets rid of all the detrimental effects off of the shield ability that he has. Yeah, So for the full thing, sword and shield. So the character has learned how to compensate for the weight of the shield in combat, no longer suffers an attack penalty while using shield defense. So this right here normally gives you an attack penalty. I mean, shield expertise and shield mastery, those are two that you gotta get as well for if you're a shield character in this game. Just because, again, it removes detrimental penalties for carrying and using a shield.
It's good to see you again, Sister Leliana.
Thank you, Sir Meron.
Is he still alive? The revered mother put him there a few weeks back. He'll be dead soon enough. The revered mother runs the chantry itself, and Sir Bryant heads the Templar stationed here. Make her watch over you.
Spawn stragglers, but no sign of the main horde. We are the only hope of protection this village has now, and I will not abandon them. That is all. May the Maker have mercy on us.
Yes? Who might you be? I am Sir Bryant, commander of Lothering's remaining Templars. You don't seem like the other refugees. Are you one of Arl Eamon's knights?
And if I were...
I tell you what I told the others. Nothing here will assist your quest. The Urn of Sacred Ashes is a myth. A mythical relic of Andraste. One of the Arl's knights, Sir Donal, is here searching for fantasies while... Never mind. Ask him if you care about this foolishness. Maker's breath. How many times must we drive them off? All of them? By yourself?
It's true. I saw it from my post. It was over so fast, we didn't even have time to get over there.
Sad that it needed to come to that. But then they asked for it. Will you accept a small reward for your service? If it interests you, there is a chanter's board outside full of quests that need doing. The chanters even offer pay for some of them.
I get them all.
Unless there's something else you need. I see. That is certainly worthy of notice. Tern Loghain declared all Grey Wardens traitors responsible for the king's death. You know this, I hope. I don't believe the Grey Wardens would be as careless or malicious as the Tern claims. But either way, there it is. It is best you not linger, though. Just in case. I cannot openly help you, I fear, but... Here, take this key. It opens the large cabinet on the far wall. There is more there than we can carry when we evacuate, so take what you need. Travel safely, and may the Maker watch over you.
Who? I beg your pardon. I did not see you approach.
Sir Donal? Is that you?
Alistair? By the Maker, how are you? I was certain you were dead.
Not yet. No thanks to Tern Loghain.
If Arl Eamon were well... He'd set Loghain straight soon enough.
So you're here looking for the Urn of Sacred Ashes, then?
I am indeed. Andraste's ashes are said to cure any illness. But I fear we are chasing a fable. With each day, my hope dims. What? And you have his locket? And a note?
Maker's mercy.
Thank you for giving me these. I would never have known otherwise. Thank you. I wonder how many of us have met similar fates on this mad quest. Why is that, if I may ask? I see. The Arl is a popular man, it's true. Tern Loghain, however, is a hero throughout Ferelden. Whatever the Tern has done or not done, the Arl remains ill or worse. That is my primary concern. The Arl fell ill before the king died. But what if Loghain planned that too? Oh, such thoughts do not sit well with me.
We should see what's happening in Redcliff ourselves. I believe that now more than ever.
If nothing else, I am certain you would be welcomed at Castle Redcliff. The Arlesa is there, and she could tell you more than I could. I expected to take advantage of the Chantry's library, in fact, but my skills are better suited to battle than chasing down tales. With Henrik gone, I need to return to Redcliff. Perhaps later I will seek out the scholar his note mentions. But I must go. Thank you again, good sir. You have been most helpful.
I do what I can to be helpful, you know.
And when the Maker spoke, chant of light scattered in the darkness. Word to spell, fear and ignorance.
Book.
Let those who cry out from the shadows come.
Updated a codex.
Redemption delivered. Let those who have sinned be forgiven.
Just like you wanted. I thought there would be soldiers here.
I'm sorry, I cannot talk now. I must feed the holy brazier to ensure the flame never dies. It represents the flames that burned Andraste herself. Do you know the tale?
Doesn't everyone?
The prophet was burned in the ancient city of Minrathus before the ancient mages she had fought. Instead of dying in pain as the mages wanted, she was purified by the fire and taken by the Maker into the heavens to stand forever at his side. We are all sinners. The fire symbolizes our hope that forgiveness is possible. Thus, we will serve by feeding its flames. I wish you well.
And then shall the Maker return to us. And then shall the Maker return to the Black City in heaven.
This is why I got that key. It's right here. Now on PC, you need to update your installation with a BioWare released mod because there's a bug where this doesn't show up. It's very annoying.
And then shall the chant of light.
But if you do not get it, you do not get the key, you will never be able to complete that armor set. Which personally I find annoying.
Good day, Sister Liliana. I'm surprised to see you're still in Lothering.
It is good to see you as well, Your Reverence.
I do not recognize your companion. Greetings. Will you be making a donation to the Chantry? Our need has never been greater. Might I suggest 30 silver? Thank you, my son. What can I do for you, then? It might have been kinder to execute him, but I leave his fate to the Maker. Why does he interest you?
I want him freed, because, well... Well, to be honest, I need help.
Then his next victims might count you and me as their murderers.
Nah, that's not intimidating.
And what do you say on this, Liliana? You know your friend better than I.
These are unusual times, Your Reverence. With us, the Qunari might do some good,
I am sure of it, in fact. Were things not so desperate? Very well, I trust you. Take these keys to his cage and make her watch over you.
Thank you, Your Reverence. Your trust is not misplaced.
Okay, so that's everything to be done in here. And I think I got all the codex to do. Nothing left on the Chanter's board.
Back off. I have the right to charge what I wish.
You profit from their misfortune. I should have the Templars give away everything in your carts.
You wouldn't dare. Any of you step too close to my goods and I'll...
It's so nice to see everyone working together in a crisis.
You got that right, Alistair.
Oh, you there. You look able. Would you care to make a tiny profit helping a beleaguered businessman?
Is your profiteering ruffling some
you
feathers?
You could say that, yes.
The nerve of these people!
He is charging outlandish prices for things people desperately need. Their blood is filling his pockets.
There's been so many of these men lately. Heartless opportunists, all.
I have limited supplies. The people decide what those supplies are worth to them.
Capitalism!
You bought most of your wares from these very people last week. Now they flee for their lives, and you want to talk business?
Look, stranger, I've 100 silvers if you drive this rabble off, starting with that priest. I'm an honest merchant, nothing more.
You don't think you're being a little unscrupulous?
Would it help these folks if they could buy no goods at all?
They spend their very last coin because they are desperate, and this man preys upon them as surely as the bandits outside the city.
Ah, I'm not arguing anymore. Drive off this woman and get your 100 silvers. Otherwise, I'm taking my wagon and leaving.
I think you can compromise and still make a profit, you know?
Perhaps. If that woman agrees, I'm allowed to charge something.
Do what you must. So long as the prices do not beggar the needy.
Fine, fine.
Because persuasion!
And since you don't look too needy, normal prices for you.
A fine compromise.
Thank you for your generous assistance. May the Maker watch over your path.
Here we go. I got some...
Don't suppose you're looking to buy something.
Grumpy.
All right. Just don't buy everything up.
Ooh, Dwarven War Axe. Okay. You're charging a lot for that crossbow, though. No, I don't have anybody that can make traps. Yeah, it's the same as the one I already got. Viridium axe, though. Does less than my steel war sword, though. got scale gloves, scale armor. I do not have scale boots. So let's get the scale boots. So we can then just have somebody wear those. Okay, now let's go get our new Canary friend and be on our way.
I have been setting down in ink the tales of our exploits, and I have been thinking about ways to describe you. You are unlike any animal I have ever met, almost human in your intelligence and understanding. So, let me see. You are loyal, yes? That one is obvious. Very, very clever. This is also obvious. You are terrifying when you have to be, but gentle and sweet as a dove at other times. And you are also playful. Sometimes gluttonous. No? What is all this begging for food scraps, then? Well, all right. You're not gluttonous. You're just a lover of fine foods. How's that?
I have finished.
And so it is done. I will follow you into battle. In doing so, I shall find my atonement. May we proceed? I am eager to be elsewhere.
Yes, we can be elsewhere.
Mighty timely arrival there, my friend.
Well done. You're welcome, Bodan.
My name's Bodan Fedic, merchant and entrepreneur. This here is my son, Sandor. Say hello, my boy.
Hello.
Road's been mighty dangerous these days. Mind if I ask what brings you out here? Perhaps we're going the same way.
It's a bit complicated, but you're welcome to come along.
Somehow I imagine that only says a half of it. Thank you for the offer, but there may be more excitement on your path than is good for my boy and me. Allow me to bid you farewell and good fortune.
Goodbye.
Now then, let's get this mess cleaned up, shall we?
Time to leave. So now we're heading to our camp.
Bad dreams, huh?
Seems well, unreal.
It is real, sort of. You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde, and we feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a blight.
That's a dragon.
I don't know if it's really a dragon, but it sure looks like one. But yes, that's the Archdemon. It takes a bit, but eventually you can block the dreams out. Some of the older Grey Wardens say they can understand the Archdemon a bit, but I sure can't. Anyhow, when I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for me, too. That's what I'm here for. To deliver unpleasant news and witty one-liners. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on.
Alright. So, first things first. Heavy chain mail. Here we go. All the heavy chain mail. And give him this great sword.
Good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fennec, at your service, once again. I saw your camp and remembered the kind offer that you made the last time we met. And is there anywhere safer for a poor merchant and his son to sleep? I think not. I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes? Anything, everything, but all of the finest quality. No cheap trinkets here. And my boy Sandal happens to be a bit of a hand with enchantments. Oh, yes. Sadly, it also makes us a target for bandits and the like. If there were spare hands to hire as guards, I would have done so long ago.
Wonderful. Free to stay.
Thank the gentleman, won't you, boy?
Thank you, sir.
We won't be a bother to you and your companions, I assure you. You should need enchantments, simply talk to my boy. Otherwise, come speak with me. Are you sure I can't interest you in this hat? A pair of earrings, perhaps? A cheese knife?
So what's your story?
Well, if you're really interested, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to tell you. I am originally from Orzammar, the famed dwarven city that lies beneath the stately Frostback Mountains. I was a merchant there, too. Merchant caste. These things are in the blood, you know. You can't just leave them behind. I ran a fairly successful business. Rare artifacts, you know. Old things. Grand things. The nobles loved them. Reminded them of the lost glory days, I suppose.
Lost glory.
Our kingdoms once spanned the length of Thedas, from majestic Orzammar to Kal Sharok to glittering Darmalin, far to the west. They say the gold and silver veins ran so thick through the stone of Darmalin that the entire city sparkled. The Darkspawn took it all, of course. One by one, the old tides fell, and then all that was left was Orzammar. But we were talking about how I ended up here, weren't we? One day, a noble woman came to my stall. She looked around for a bit and then started shrieking in dismay. Apparently, she believed that a pair of braces I had for sale once belonged to her brother. He'd been lost in a cave-in, you see, while on an expedition to clear out the Darkspawn from one of the tunnels running close to the city. They were made specially for him. They're unique, she shrieked. He stole them from my poor brother's corpse. She had me arrested on the spot, of course. Nobles, they're touchy like that.
I can understand why she'd be upset.
I didn't steal them. You see, I had been paying these castless thugs to venture out into the deep roads for me. The Lost Tigers. They're full of things that people left behind. Sometimes you can find a treasure. Something worth a little gold. That's exactly how I see it. The noblewoman, she wasn't too happy with the theft of her brother's braces. I don't know what they planned for me, and I didn't want to find out. Bribed the guard that was watching me and took off for the surface first opportunity I got. Never looked back. I thank the stone every single day. Now, is there anything the boy or I can get you? Ah, yes. I'm married to a fine woman back in Denerim, it's true. She'd give me a son if she could, but that's not likely to ever be. Sandal here. I found him in the deep roads years ago. Abandoned, I think. And he was never quite right in the head. I took him in, and I brought him with me when I came here to the surface. He may not be my blood, true, but I think of him as one.
We left Orzammar.
That's right, boy. Maybe one day we'll see it again. That's how I've always felt. As long as he's happy, so am I. It's not as if I don't benefit, mind you. Turns out the boy's a natural working with enchantments. He might have even been lyrium-addled. I never thought of that before, to be honest. Happens sometimes. He can work an enchantment into just about anything, however, given some time. Could probably open his own shop, if he knew how.
Enchantment.
Well, he does seem to enjoy it, at least. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Discount? Okay. So we don't have much right now. Oops, spirit hands. Let me see this. Plus 10% spirit. Nope. No, I didn't want to buy.
You and your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Imperial Weavers and some Spirit Hands for me? That. Save up for those. Alistair Dahl, Kmart Shield, and Qunari Pinners for the dead. Alright, Kmart Shield, it doesn't go to you.
A fine gift. You.
Alright, I didn't pick up the stick. But I can get rid of the beef bone.
Oh, how dear of you.
Unexpected.
You and your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road.
Let's see.
I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Something I can help with? Yes? What's on your mind? My mother was from Denerim, and I consider myself a Ferelden. Mother served an Orlesian noblewoman who lived here when Orle ruled. When Orle was defeated, and the common folk began to resent the presence of any Orlesian, the lady returned to Orle. She took my mother with her. I was born in Orle, and did not set foot in Ferelden till much later. Mother was always telling me stories of her homeland. I think she missed it. She had served Cecily, the Lady Cecily, for many years, and was loyal to her.
I think I might have messed something up.
Cecily was a good person. She was always kind to me. Mother died when I was very young. Lady Cecily let me stay with her. I had no one else. She was quite old then, and she had me study music and dance to entertain her. It is unfair that I have more memories of Cecily than my mother. Strangely, the only thing I really remember of Mother was her scent. She kept dried flowers in her closet amongst her clothes. Small white Ferelden wildflowers with a sweet fragrance. Mother called them Andraste's Grace. They were very rare in Orle. But enough about that. Let us move on.
I think I messed it up.
Something I can help with? Yes? What's on your mind?
Yeah. I messed it up. Redo it because I messed something up.
Bad dreams, huh? Well, it is real, sort of. You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde, and we feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a blight. I don't know if it's really a dragon, but it sure looks like one. But yes, that's the Archdemon. It takes a bit, but eventually you can block the dreams out. Some of the older Grey Wardens say they can understand the Archdemon a bit, but I sure can't. Anyhow, when I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for me, too. That's what I'm here for. To deliver unpleasant news and witty one-liners. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on.
Okay. So, before we do anything else...
Yes? Well, here I am.
See, this is the conversational line that I wanted. You can only do it at this time. Like, the minute you start moving her affinity for you past this, or you go past this point, you cannot get this line anymore.
What is meant by someone like me? Did you think I was always a cloistered sister? The Chantry provides succor and safe harbor to all who seek it. I chose to stay and become affirmed.
Affirmed?
We affirm our belief in the Maker, in Andraste and the Chant, but other than that, there are no vows taken.
Oh. Why were you looking for
the Chantry does not thrive, and you should. I desired time apart from the world. I was a traveling minstrel in Orlais. Tales and songs were my life. I performed, and they rewarded me with applause and coin. And my skill in battle? Well, you pick up different skills when you travel, yes? Yes, of course. Let's move on.
Okay. So I've got the dialogue option that I wanted. Now I can do all the other stuff I wanted to do.
Ah, it's good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fennec, at your service, once again. I saw your camp and remembered the kind offer that you made the last time we met. And is there anywhere safer for a poor merchant and his son to sleep? I think not. I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes? Anything, everything, but all of the finest quality. No cheap trinkets here. And my boy Sandal happens to be a bit of a hand with enchantments. Oh, yes. Sadly, it also makes us a target for bandits and the like. If there were spare hands to hire as guards, I would have done so long ago. Wonderful. Thank the gentleman, won't you, boy?
Thank you, sir.
We won't be a bother to you and your companions, I assure you. If you should need enchantments, simply talk to my boy. Otherwise, come speak with me. You and your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Need some spirit hands. Need to sell junk. And prayers for the dead. There you go. So here we go, let's try this again, giving you the loot.
Oh, how dear of you. Thank you so much.
A fine gift. You have my thanks.
And can
unexpected. Thank you.
So there we go. Pretty sure you like this.
That's a wonderful thought. I don't know what to say.
Say thank you. Let's start there. I think that's a really good place to start, you know. By saying thank you. Okay. Most excellent. The enchantment.
Hello.
The boy's a bit simple, but He's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a... what was it now? A savant. I had no idea such a thing existed. He can fold lyrium into almost any weapon or piece of armor, though naturally some of the more extravagant materials will take more lyrium than others. It's a process that some of the master smiths back in Orzammar will perform, but my boy here is just as adept at it. Isn't that right, boy?
Enchantment!
And there you have it.
Enchantment! Well, we enchant some stuff. Damn it. Excuse me again. Okay, so that's the only thing I've got worth enchanting. Talk to Levi.
You're a hard man to find. Where are my manners? The name is Levi. Levi Dryden. Did Duncan ever mention me?
No.
Levi of the coins?
Nope.
Levi the trader?
Nope. I'm Gillet, and I've never heard of you.
Really? He never told you of old Levi? We've known each other for years. But here I am carrying on while you have a blight to stop. Don't want to waste your time. But you see, Duncan promised that together we'd look into something important for the Wardens. And for me. But poor Duncan's... well, no more. A tragedy it is, at that. What I know he would want his work carried on, his pledge fulfilled. My family, well, past a bit checkered, you see. Nobles look at us with disdain. My great-great-grandmother, Sophia Dryden, was the last Warden Commander of Ferelden back when the Wardens were known as Freeloaders. So King Arlen banished the Wardens, and he took House Dryden's land and titles.
Bit drastic, isn't
it? And then some. Not much is known about that time. After King Arlen died, there was a civil war, loads worse than this one. And our family was on the run, hunted by enemies, with nary a friend in the world. But Drydens are tough. We rebuilt, became merchants, and we never lost our pride.
So,
ask for the truth.
What did you ask for?
My family reveres Sophia Dryden. We know she died at the old Grey Warden base, Soldier's Peak. We want evidence to clear her name. It won't restore our land or our titles, but it'll restore our honor. Well, no one's been to Soldier's Peak since Arlen's days. At least none that's come back. I spent years mapping the maze of tunnels to the peak, and I found the way a few years back. So I went to Duncan, I did, and I said that he could reclaim the old base and my family could have its honor. Soldier's Peak is strategic and symbolic importance. Duncan said that it would be worth it right there. He also hoped to recover lost Warden history and perhaps a few old relics. No one knows what's up there now.
I will help you.
A thousand blessings upon you, Warden.
Let's go
mark down
take
the location
out
on
Soldier's
your map.
Peak.
When you arrive,
whatever
we'll pick
is
our
there.
Way through the tunnels together.
something I can help with? Yes? What's on your mind?
I have heard that in Orlais, minstrels are often spies.
Where did you hear this?
I read it in a history book.
And did you not think that this could be historical fact and no longer true? Not all minstrels are spies. Most are just singers and storytellers. But some of them are what we call bards.
And the bards are spies. And I thought that minstrels were bards.
Many use the two words minstrel and bard interchangeably. But to do so in Orlais would cause misunderstanding. Bards are minstrels and more. Spies, as you say. Some say there is a bard order, but I don't think this is true. Many bards work alone or in small groups, doing the bidding of a patron who pays for their services. If there is an organization behind it all, no one knows who they are. What do you think? They infiltrate, steal, sometimes assassinate. It depends on the bard. In Orlais, there is much rivalry amongst the highborn. They fight over land, influence, and the favor of the Empress. But they cannot do this openly because it is impolite. And in public, they wear smiling faces and pretend to be civil. In secret, they plot and scheme to destroy each other. It is a game completely meaningless to anyone but its players.
Yeah, ain't that right?
And I shouldn't I, after having spent most of my adult life as one? You've guessed as much, I'm sure. But does it really matter what I was? What's past is past. I found myself in Ferelden, and sheltered from bad weather in the Chantry. And when the storm passed, I just did not want to leave.
Don't believe it.
I like to see the Maker brought me here.
I await your command. At times, perhaps, a world full of people and buildings and things was all very foreign to me. If I wished companionship, I ran with the wolves and flew with the birds. If I spoke, 'twas to the trees. Such simple pleasures will only enthrall for so long. I recall the first time I crept beyond the edge of the wilds. I did so in animal form, remaining in the shadows and watching these strange townsfolk from afar. I happened upon a noblewoman by her carriage, adorned in sparkling garments the likes of which I had never before seen. I was dazzled. This, to me, seemed what true wealth and beauty must be. I snuck up behind her and stole a hand mirror from the carriage. It was encrusted in gold and crystalline gemstones, and I hugged it to my chest with delight as I sped back to the wilds.
I can't believe Flemeth was like that.
She was not. Flemeth was furious with me. I was a child and had not yet come into my full power, and I had risked discovery for the sake of a pretty bauble. To teach me a lesson, Flemeth took the mirror and smashed it upon the ground. I was heartbroken. Beauty and love are fleeting and have no meaning. Survival has meaning. Power has meaning. Without those lessons, I would not be here today, as difficult as they might have been. They did indeed. To return to your original question, perhaps my time in the wilds was indeed lonely, but such was how it had to be. I find myself at times wondering what might have become of the girl with the beautiful golden mirror, but such fantasies have no place amidst reality.
You are not quite as callow as I thought. That is unexpected. You're welcome. Speak, then. Then I suggest we move on. Does it matter? Very well. I caged myself. A weak mind is a deadly foe, as you are no doubt aware.
Yep.
I came to your lands with seven of the Beresad, my brothers, to seek answers about the Blight. We made our way across the Ferelden countryside without incident, seeing nothing of the threat we were sent to observe. Until the night we camped by Lake Callenhad. They came from everywhere. The earth beneath our feet, the air above us. Our own shadows harbored the darkspawn. I saw the last of the creatures cut down, too late. I fell. I heard the stories of Ostagar. Your kith stood their ground when others fled. No one can do more than that. I don't know how long I lay on the battlefield among the dead. Nor do I know how the farmers found me. I only know that when I woke, I was no longer among my brothers. And my sword was gone from my hand. I searched for it. And when that failed, I asked my rescuers what had become of it. I killed them. With my bare hands. I did. I knew they didn't have the blade. They had no reason to lie to me. I panicked. Unthinking, I struck them down. That sword was made for my hand alone. I have carried it from the day I was set into the Beresad. I was to die wielding it for my people. Even if I could cross Ferelden and Teventer unarmed and alone to bring my report to the Arishok, I would be slain on sight by the Antam. They would know me as Solas, a deserter. No soldier would cast aside his blade while he drew breath. If I knew where to look, it would be in my hand now. Near Lake Callenhad. Perhaps those words are empty, but thank you all the same.
Yay! Stand personal quest.
Indeed.
Yes.
Yes.
So first we'll go to the Lake Callenhad docks. Start there.
Back off! I was here first! That doesn't matter none to you. I'm an honest businessman. I wasn't bothering nobody, and I was here first. Why, you looking to buy one?
No, but my very large angry friend here is.
Oh, is he? Well, that's... See, I'd like to sell you one, but I don't, have any myself. I got part of a glove the wolves didn't chew too badly, though. I think it was a glove, anyway. I know, don't say it. I got cheated. I knew the guy who was here before me. He sold me this spot. Said he found giants and all kind of crazy valuables. He didn't mention that he'd taken everything but the bones and the dirt already. His name's Ferrin. Squirrely little bastard, if you ask me. Which you didn't, but I said it anyway. He was going to Orzammar, he said. I imagine he's gotten there by now. If you find him, tell him I sent you. It'll scare the piss out of him.
Okay. We're done here for now. Oh, crud.
Will you stop eating?
I'm hungry.
Stuff your face at camp. For now, watch the bloody road.
But we've been looking at the road for hours. No travelers all day.
Will one of you pay attention?
Oi! Who's that?
Eh, I shouldn't have listened for so long.
Yes. What is it?
Shokke basit hisra, marade starit, merade twasit, abana kyun, maras shokra, ananne sam kyun.
Here I am. It's done.
Good.
finished. Trap right ahead. Why always attracting danger? As you like.
What now?
Here!
Of course.
As for violence is a solution. Sometimes.
All right.
We have done well.
Of course.
Something I can help with?
As you desire. Delighted.
So, here we go. Those random encounters are kind of annoying. Save. Because, yeah, our last major save was in Ostagar. That was a long time ago. That was like 3 hours ago. Hey, Deathroot. See, this is why we save. This right here is why we save. So we'll come back and do this later, maybe. All the way to Soldier's Peak.
And here we are, Soldier's Peak. Maker's Breath. Look at the size of her. What a fortress. I told you the map would get us through the tunnels. It's just teeming with history. Can't you feel it? So, I'll follow you about from a distance. This place has the stench of death. I expect there's trouble up ahead.
Soldier's Peak. Looks like it's seen better days. Better centuries, more like.
Got everybody? Good, because here we go. Actually, let me check Alistair's weapon.
Fall back! Fall back already!
Taking the peak will not be easy, my lord.
I gave the Waltons one chance to die with honor. Instead, they hole up like cowards. We follow the king's advice, then. Starve them out.
But the peak has months of supplies.
Then we wait. When they are too weak to lift their weapons, we will send them to their final judgment.
What was that? Felt a bit woozy there. I'm not mad, am I? You saw it too.
I've heard an Orlesian ballad about something like this. A beauty trapped in a dream. In the song, Belisa never wakes up.
Your prissy friend here is making me nervous, Warden. How's this even possible? The place must truly be haunted.
Yes.
The Veil?
Never mind.
Yes, Warden.
I think that's a cool. Looks dead, right?
Defend yourself!
So I shall.
Looks like it was a secret passage in and out. Maybe. Here we go.
The men's morale is low.
My spells are of no use in this matter, Commander.
There is more to leading men than sorcery, Avernus. I will remind them that they're wardens. Men, I won't lie to you. The situation is grim. Our forces outnumbered, our bellies empty, and our hearts are sagging. But we are wardens! Darkspawn flee when they hear our horns. Archdemons die when they taste our blades. So are we to bend knee to a mere human despot? No! I, for one, will never give up! I, for one, will never surrender just to dance on Arlen's gallows. So I propose here and now, in these hallowed halls where generations of our brethren stood vigil against darkspawn and evil, that we send a message to that fat bastard. In this sacred place, proud men, strong men, stood defiant, and would rather die than submit to tyranny.
So brave, even when starving, and my great-great-grandmother stood with them. Not much is known of King Arland. The War of Succession that followed his death, now that was a piece of work. Lasted nearly a decade, and almost burned Denerim and the palace to the ground. Loads of history was lost, but maybe there's answers to that inside. But I've gabbed enough. Lead on, my friend.
There are a lot of people. Oh, wrong way. Liliana lived up. So, most important things are cunning and dexterity. so we can unlock more chests. Need to check every room, you know. Never know what you'll find. Nope, can't go that way.
Now, now, what's all this?
Hold, Archivist.
Almost done. The truth must be told.
What does it matter? We're dead.
Our grand rebellion so close. And to die here, a stillbirth.
We never should have done it. Wardens aren't supposed to oppose kings and princes.
Should we stand idly by?
Another one. Rebellion? What's this about a rebellion? If only the book weren't burned. We can only hope.
Yeah. Place is a little on the creepy side, to be honest. Kinda gives you the collywobbles. Hey, I was walking.
Make them pay for every inch, men! Hold the flank! Avernus, we need you!
Nelarteb Obrosov Sivan Netbeth.
Andraste's blood! What?
More Avernus! Whatever it takes!
K.E.A. Benfotos Victos!
Press them! Press them now!
No! I command you, fight the king's men!
Fool! So much death! Suffering, and oh yes, blood. The veil is torn now. Your soul is mine, Avernus.
Acolytes, retreat now. The battle is lost.
Avernus!
What just happened? Oh no, more fighting.
Shout.
The wardens summoned demons. Can't believe it. And my grandmother, she knew. I believed that my family was better than that. But answers may lay up ahead.
One can only hope. Yes. What? No. I need 36 magic to be able to use this thing.
Step no further, Warden. This one would speak with you. Fool!
All the noise!
I do really badly back there.
Done.
Cracked skull.
You want? It is done. Shokke basit hisra, marade starit, merade twasit, abana kyun, maras shokra, ananne sam kyun.
There we go, we've got revival now. And super awesome. So yeah, things have been going well now that we're longer trying to.
Yourself.
What do you need?
Soldier's Peak DLC is pretty handy because this gives me a keep that I can go ahead and have a stash in.
Deal with these ones and move on. They like it. Ability notes. Abilities, I like this. Old research of Avernus. Series of experiments.
Day 32. The subject is not responding to the stimuli. Testing the pain threshold has uncovered nothing. Only three subjects are left. Day 82. If only I could reproduce last night's extraordinary success. Electricity is only a catalyst. The blood is the key. Day 97. Energy and blood. Repeated applications have duplicated the results. I conjecture that success can be induced alchemically. But there are no more subjects left. If only I had one more, or a dozen. The things I could do.
I'm gonna drink it. As horrible as an idea this sounds, I'm gonna drink it. Yay, new abilities. New abilities, good. Book. Avernus's notes. Codex.
I hear you. Don't disrupt my concentration. Even now, the demons seek to replenish their numbers. Are you to thank for this welcomed but temporary imbalance? Only just. I have only a short time left.
Careful. This man has dabbled in matters forbidden by the Maker. He may look frail, but don't trust him.
So the Maker told you that, did he? Short-sighted men have forbidden my research, not any god. Enough. Why are you here? What is your intent?
I'm here to recover the Grey Warden book.
An admirable goal. But in order to achieve this, the demons must be cut off forever. To what questions, I wonder, ask?
Master Mage, sir, my family name has been worth less than dirt for over a century. Do you have any proof that Sophia was a hero?
The boy who braved the mists. So you heeded my call. And you are a Dryden. The cosmos has a sense of humor. He was but a boy when he entered the tunnels below the peak. His heart pure, his character certain. In dreams, I gave him the keys he would need. He would be my deliverance. Your great-great-grandmother was the best of us. Brave, charismatic, fiery, utterly devoted to the fight. But still we lost.
Yep.
We fought against a tyrant, you know, so full of vigor then, so blind to consequence. But proof? There's none to be had.
I had hoped. But thank you, Warden.
Time for questions.
So be it. My only request, if justice or vengeance drive you, stay your hand until the demons are dealt with.
Demons must
be stopped.
We must
go to the Great Hall. There, I will repair the damage I caused so long ago. There will be peril. The demons will fight us every step of the way. Come.
Yep. But first, final codex piece, the history of Soldier's Peak.
We must act quickly. The demons are clawing on the gates. The veil must be closed.
I will
unravel the summoning circles I drew so long ago. Waves of spirits and demons may come through. Dispatch them. I will begin. First, I must summon the magical energies. I feel them. They're coming.
I wonder. That's an Illuvion there. I feel like it might be. Fire, heal.
Be careful! Let's make this quick!
Here we go, healed. Okay. That one. Now he die. No, I'm gonna die. No. Haha, see that, I didn't die. Ow, 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 ow. Crushing prison, ow. Yeah, Alistair leveled up.
Are we stopping? As you wish.
Yeah, 3 gold. Yeah, doesn't this look like an alluvion? Looks like an alluvion to me.
It's over. The veil is strong now. Stronger, at least. So what of me? Will you leave me to experiment in peace? Without test subjects, without other materials, you would cripple my efforts. But I will do what I can in this endeavor. I have little hope of discovering anything useful. But if I do, you will hear of it.
You've done it, Warden. Soldier's Peak is safe again. That old geezer Avernus deserves the gallows, if you ask me, but people will do queer things to survive. But if he does the proper research, without the sacrifices and blood magic and all, maybe he'll turn up something good. But there was no proof to redeem my family. Well, thanks, Warden. For so long, I was focused on the past. On answers. But I think I would have been better off had I stayed at home. Enough of that, though. I find myself at a loss. You've got a whole fortress now. I suppose I should start plying my trade again. You know I'm no good in a fight, but I'm a fair trader if I do say so myself. My cousins have been looking for a safe place to store trade goods, and the Peak will do nicely. Whatever the Drydens have to offer are yours, for a sizable discount.
Looks like we're done here. A demonic invasion thwarted, a Warden base safely rescued. We do good work.
And Sten leveled up. Yeah, level 9. Sten level 9. Add to your constitution. Tactics. Bravery. We'll go with Shattering Blows so he does more damage. Hey, look, a secret tunnel. A secret stash. Awesome. Love secret stash. Now let's go back to camp and come back.
I lied to you, you know, about why I left Orle.
Why?
I didn't feel like talking about it then, what happened to me. Maybe it will affect us, maybe not, but you should know. I came to Ferelden and the Chantry because I was being hunted in Orle. I was framed, betrayed by someone I thought I knew and could trust. Marjolaine. She was my mentor and friend. She taught me the bardic arts, how to enchant with words and song, to carry myself like a highborn lady, to blend in as a servant. The skills I learned, I used to serve her, my bardmaster, because I loved her, and because I enjoyed what I did. You can say it was my fault. There was a man I was sent to kill. I was to bring Marjolaine everything he carried. I don't know who this man was. She gave me a name and a description, and I hunted him down. I found documents on his body, sealed documents. It turns out that they were. My curiosity got the better of me. Something told me that I needed to know what was in those letters. Marjolaine had been selling all kinds of information about Orle to other countries, Nevara and Antiva among others. It was treason. Some. But I had always assumed Marjolaine only operated within Orle. This was an unhappy surprise for me. My life as Bard taught me that my loyalties should be kept fluid. My concern was not that she was a traitor, but that her life would be in danger if she was caught. Orle has been at war with so many countries, it takes a harsh view of such things, as I later discovered. I should have left well alone, but I didn't. I had to tell Marjolaine I feared for her life. She brushed aside my concern. She admitted her guilt, but said it was in the past. That is why the documents had to be destroyed, she said. I believed her. I kept believing up till the moment they showed me the documents, altered by her hand to make me look the traitor. The Orlesian guards, they captured me. Did terrible things. To make me confess and reveal my conspirators. It was a traitor's punishment I endured. And at the end of it, all that awaited me was eternity in an unmarked grave. The skills Marjolaine taught me were good for something, at least. I broke free when I saw the opportunity. I did not seek Marjolaine out. If she thought I was coming for her, she would have me caught again. I was tempted to confront her. I was furious, betrayed. But what could I do against her? And so I fled to Ferelden, to the Chantry and the Maker. Ferelden protected my person, and the Maker saved my soul. And that is the reason I am here. The real reason. No more lies between us, at least in this.
Thank you for trusting.
It feels good to have this off my chest. Thank you for listening and understanding.
Okay, I think that is a good spot to stop for today. Don't you? So, let's go ahead and send everybody who's here on over. Beach, just just started streaming.